You're watching Channel 7 Action News.
All right, did you watch for your favorites? Yeah. A few commercials in the Super Bowl turned in performances worthy of the big stage.
And Action News reporter Vic Faust tells us who finished at the top of the list.
63 different commercials took center stage last night. Some succeeded with the viewers, others did not. Dr. Michael Bernacki is a marketing professor at the University of Detroit Mercy, who has been hosting his Super Bowl ad nauseum since 1985, breaking down commercials with high school and college students, and he was surprised to see Snickers take number one with Betty White.
The Snickers has had some problems in the past here and there. Well, they won the ad meter this year. And, you know, they had a little bit of everything in there. By the way, the number one component of most of these ads is violence.
The second highest rated ad also featured violence. It was courtesy of Doritos. It was the dog in anti-bark collar. Bud Light took number three with Man Builds Beer Can House. And Anheuser-Busch also scored well with their Clydesdales piece. But according to Dr. Bernacki, AB had a rough night.
Probably the big loser for the first time ever was Anheuser-Busch. And the reason I say that is they had trouble maintaining focus, you know, in the top 10 of the ad meter.
Bernacki was impressed with Doritos and their user-generated ads, specifically the Hands Off My Mama commercial.
Hands on my Doritos.
What didn't do so well with the American people was GoDaddy.com. Two of their Danica Patrick ads finished in the bottom four, including last place.
Wow. Okay.
So some of your favorites.
So I did like the Betty White. You call it violent, or they called it violent.
Violence.
The Snickers one with Betty White, I mean, come on, it was fun violence, right?
Fun violence for a few of us, at least. There are some people that think it's violence, or at least it's termed violence, but it was number one.
By far,
it was number one. And you know what else did well last night?
The E-Trades, right?
The E-Trades did well, but they didn't finish in the top five, but they were scored very highly. Okay. Leno, Letterman, Oprah.
That was clever. That did well.
Not in the top five. We talked about the top three. Another interesting was the Census Bureau. I hope everybody liked it because your tax dollars paid for that one. They did it in 2000. They did it again in 2010 now. So all in all, Dr. Bernacki thought it was a pretty good night. Yeah. Better than last year, but once again, he talked about the losers, Anheuser-Busch. Snickers did well. Doritos doing very well, too.
Yeah, I did like Snickers. And you know what? Nothing would have topped that Oprah Letterman Leno one unless that had been counted, right?
Had it been Leno and counted first and made it a better 30-second ad. Yeah. You got it.
Right. It made a lot of fun, though, anyway, didn't it?